We're now going to hear from another key plaintiff in this lawsuit, Tara Pino.
Good morning. My name is Tara Pino. In 2006, when I was a 31-year-old graduate student, another driver ran a stop sign and totaled my car. For the next 3 years, I struggled to recover and at times wondered if I would ever regain the use of my right hand. I had insurance, both medical and auto. The driver who hit me also was insured and admitted fault. Despite this, I was first denied coverage for the surgery to restore the use of my hand that had been recommended by my doctor. My medical insurance flat out said no. 9 months later, after wrangling, I finally won the right to have the surgery recovered. And it would be another year before I was fully recovered from that surgery and the nerve damage repaired to the extent that it has. However, the legal settlement was not enough to cover the expenses caused by the accident. I also found that with a pre-existing condition and being self-employed, I was unable to find affordable insurance. Once the Affordable Care Act passed, I was relieved that there would be insurance exchanges and rules preventing my exclusion from insurance. The past 2 years, I have been counting down to 2014 and staying home with my son. Since being pregnant, I have been able to qualify for Medicaid, but to keep my coverage, I cannot earn more than $900 a month. With the expense of childcare, the kind of work that I can do now is very limited, and the risk of losing insurance for me and my son weighs heavily in every decision that I make. When Attorney General Rob McKenna filed suit against the Affordable Care Act, I found myself feeling extremely vulnerable again, unsure of what would happen to me if the law was overturned by the Supreme Court. With so many threats to Medicaid, I don't feel like it's safe to depend on it either. And though I'm grateful to have it, Medicaid is also limited and doesn't offer treatment for the chronic issues still ongoing from the car accident. I would like to go back to work. I still have dreams of being a small business owner. But instead of pursuing my career, I'm feeling trapped. If I earn more than $900 a month, I lose the coverage that I have. If I go to work for someone else, how will I pay for childcare? I'm only 37 years old. I've already been pushed to the brink of bankruptcy because of medical bills. I'm facing permanent nerve damage, and my health care coverage, which could be guaranteed by the ACA, is at stake. I understand that the Attorney General might have felt he had reason to file a suit based on what he believed, but he is misrepresenting the wishes of the people of Washington State. Ever since the ACA became law, I have been hopeful that there would be a time when I could find health care for me and my family that we could afford. But what Rob McKenna has done by participating in this suit could instead take that hope away from me and other women and families in the state of Washington.